Hi everyone, I'm Laurencio, and in this video I'm going to talk about all Pro Evolution Soccer games for the Sony PSP. Enjoy! The PES games are marvelous games. In this video, you will see how many PES games were released for the Sony PSP, and I'm going to try list differences within the games, so that you know what exactly changes from game to game. First off, we have Pro Evolution Soccer 5, which is a remarkable port of the PS2 game. The graphics look pretty close, and the only seeming difference is that by lacking the L2 and R2 buttons, you have to double tap the shoulder buttons. Other than that, there's no Master League mode. You have only national and international leagues. But aside from this, it's a great game. It even has an edit mode and a pass shop with an unlockable expert difficulty level and a big array of teams. Also, the games have ad hoc multiplayer, all of them. So you can play with a friend next to you a quick match. Pro Evolution Soccer 6 brings improvements. The loading times are shorter, even though still not short enough. The shooting mechanic has been tweaked and is now less forgiving. And the teams have been updated, of course. Winning 11 Pro Evolution Soccer 2007 is another great game of the franchise. This time, you get more game modes. You get League mode, a kind of season mode that takes your favorite team through a number of matches in a single or multiple seasons. Then there's Cup mode, a mode that allows you to compete in a number of cup competitions like the International Cup or the made-up Konami Cup. And it also has a training mode, which all the games have, and the game also has the beloved Master League mode again. In Pro Evolution Soccer 2008, the gameplay mechanic got more arcade-ish, so that you can dribble more easily and score a tiny bit easier, unless you play on hard difficulties, because then scoring really is hard. In rest, you get the same game modes and the same graphics, but different and updated teams, of course. In Pro Evolution Soccer 2009, you get a new mode, the Become a Legend mode, where you create a character and play with him till he gets popular and great and a great player and a myth and a legend and stuff like that. It's a fun mode. In rest, the game seems to be the same. Sure, there are updated teams and menus, and the game is smoother and slightly tweaked, but aside from the new game mode, it is very similar to the previous one. In Pro Evolution Soccer 2010, the biggest change comes in the menus. Now you get player cards. With them, the statistics of each player are more clearly put, so you know how well he does in terms of stamina, power, passing and so on, and that is really useful when building a team. Also, this installment brings new game modes like the UEFA Champions League and the community area, where you can keep track of the scores between you and your friends from when you play in ad hoc. Also, the game is smoother now and slight performance changes have been made. In Pro Evolution Soccer 2011, the gameplay seems more indulgent now, and the passing system is way better now. The graphics are slightly better, and so are the controls and how the game behaves. There seem not to be any new game modes. The teams are updated as usual, and now you can create a friend card. What is that? Well, it's a card that after you play a match with a friend, he will have your card on his PSP and you will have his on your own, on your PSP. In rest, the game seems to deliver the same experience. In Pro Evolution Soccer 2012, it's really hard to spot anything different from 2011. Even the game developers said that they didn't have in mind to bring something new, because they wanted to perfect the gameplay on a profound level. But to me, the game plays the same. Just the teams are updated, as usual. In rest, it's still PES 2011. In Pro Evolution Soccer 2013, I couldn't find anything new, aside from the updated teams of course, but gameplay-wise and graphic-wise, it looks just like the previous game. So the game developers went on to the saying, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I guess. And the last one, Pro Evolution Soccer 2014 doesn't bring news either. But why did they make one for the PSP in 2014? Well, because there was high demand of the game franchise for the PSP even in that year, 2014, especially from Latin America and Asia. So they made another game. Because the guys at Konami said that the people from Latin America and Asia will probably be slower to adapt to new consoles than Europe. So they made a new game for the PSP. Okay, so this was the video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe. And if you want, follow me on Twitch, Instagram or Discord. I left the links to those in the video description. Thank you.